What is Dihexa? Well, for those of you who have been living under a rock, no, I'm joking. It's a very complex peptide structure that a lot of people don't know anything about. And so in this video, what I'm going to show you is exactly what Dihexa is, how it works in your body, the natural pathways that it optimizes, and then I'll even share with you some of the insights that I've gleaned by using Dihexa for over 10 years. So let's jump into the science. Okay, first of all, what even is Dihexa? As my kids would say, what even is that? Well, Dihexa has cognitive enhancing benefits. It improves cognitive function, it improves memory acquisition and consolidation and retrieval. It enhances learning capacity, recall, and problem-solving skills. It also increases mental stamina, focus, and conversational skills. And so Dihexa is interesting because it's a peptide structure. And this peptide structure has been studied extensively. Originally, what they found is it works on the angiotensin IV pathway, and it's considered an angiotensin IV analog. And Dihexa binds to, with high affinity, to certain receptors in the brain that activate this receptor called c-MET receptor. And that pathway is critical for neurogenesis. So when Dihexa activates that c-MET receptor, you're going to see that you start to grow new neurons and you get this new synaptic energy. Now, one of the videos that I saw about 3 years ago was fascinating to me because they took a patient who was learning complex subjects and they were able to map out the brain and watch these little neurons and these dendrites grow while the person was learning new things. And you can see it in real time. And the fascinating thing about this is, you know, Dihexa has been shown to have that neurogenesis. So unlike stimulants or some of these short-acting nootropics, what Dihexa does is it creates long-term changes in your brain. And it's a simple peptide structure that allows you to improve learning capacity. It also allows you to recover if you've had traumatic brain injuries or something like PTSD. And what sets Dihexa apart from other nootropics or even other peptides is its ability to cross through the blood-brain barrier and actually access the parts of your brain that we all want to access so that we can be the super version of ourselves. So Dihexa, some of the studies are very interesting, and I'll share with you these studies. One of the studies, they found that it stimulates the growth of new neurons. It increases synaptic density, and synaptic density is what you want, so you have better electrical conductivity in the brain, and you have more neurotransmitter excretion. Dihexa promotes dendritic spine formation at a rate significantly higher than BDNF. What that means is you're going to have about 7 times more potent dendritic formations from Dihexa than even BDNF alone, or brain-derived neurotropic factor. It facilitates neuronal regeneration and differentiation, and it helps recover from any kind of spinal injuries. The other studies show that it protects against neurodegeneration, and one of the first things that it was researched for is Alzheimer's disease and Parkinson's disease. So what they found is Dihexa actually helped with the removal of some of that amyloid beta plaque that can accumulate with Alzheimer's, and then it also helps reduce oxidative stress and allows for greater levels of dopamine in Parkinson's patients. One of the studies, they found that it helped manage depression and improved overall mood and motivation. And users reported increased mental clarity, energy, and drive that contributed to overall confidence and vitality. If you think about with Dihexa, if you're using it on more of a consistent basis, some of the lost motor function started to recover in, this was in rodent models where they had neurological damage, and they found that after 34 days of treatment, things started to improve. They also took this into the human model with Parkinson's disease and preclinical trials, and they found the same thing, that the motor repair started to take place about 34 days after treatment. And they found that there is an enormous amount of increase in the dendritic spine in the hippocampal neurons just after 5 days of administration. So that indicates more synaptic connectivity. And if you think of the hippocampal region, a lot of us, we lose our ability to have spatial awareness as we age. We get more clumsy. We drop things more frequently. And that's because the hippocampal volume starts to shrink, and then our bodies don't have the same coordination that they once did. But what Dihexa has been proven to do is to reactivate the dendrites, or these little nerves, in the back of the brain, in the hippocampal region. Some of the early clinical models, they found that there was enhanced memory recall, faster learning, improved focus, better mental stamina. They also found that there is improvement in mental agility and energy and motivation. While Dihexa is still, there's a lot of research that's being done, one of the things that we're realizing is the side effect profile is very, very small to none. And it's such a powerful peptide that your brain actually can recover much quicker, even if you've had like traumatic stress in your life, because some of these emotions can hijack our memory. And when you have this new, what's called neurogenesis, so the new formation of neurons, then it allows your brain to have more adaptability. Your body gets stuck less in that fight or flight response. So one of the studies that I found was interesting, it was published about 10 years ago. And what they did at the Harvard Medical School is they did these functional MRIs, and they wanted to see the difference in people who had PTSD. They wanted to look at the volume of the brain, and they wanted to see if there is any kind of an anatomical changes in the brain. And they found that people who had high levels of anxiety and PTSD, they actually had a shrinkage in their prefrontal cortex, whereas their amygdala, or the part of the brain that regulates the autonomic nervous system or fight or flight, their amygdalas were overexpressed and larger. So one of the things that our bodies and our brains do to adapt is our brains actually start forcing more of those stress hormones into that amygdala, or you know, the part of the brain that's closest to the spinal cord, which is the first version of the brain to form. And then it takes away energy from the prefrontal cortex, which is where a lot of our logic and reasoning takes place. What's really interesting about the human brain, and when you're looking at Dihexa to amplify it, is we have this very complex structure, but if we don't manage our emotions, it can really get in the way. One of my friends, Joey Klein, he wrote a book called The Inner Matrix System. And he created an entire training protocol off of his work that he's done working with world-class neurologists and also going to India and studying with some of the gurus there that had him do these crazy silent meditations for days on end with very little food and not the most comfortable conditions. But what Joey did is he was able to learn how to calm down that aspect of the brain. And he noticed that his learning capabilities increased, his happiness increased. And then he shared his knowledge with over 85,000 people. And I've been fortunate enough to go through his training and learn a lot about that emotional reactivity. So if you're looking at Dihexa and you're looking to recover from, you know, a history of anxiety, depression, any kind of mental health issue, then Dihexa is a really great peptide to utilize right up front, because it's like putting new life into your brain. The other thing that can help activate that pathway in your brain and create new life is using a nasal spray of intranasal stem cells. And this is where our doctors use a device called the sphenocath, and you just put a little bit of stem cell into the back of the sinuses where they can migrate through the sphenopalatine ganglion and the olfactory nerves. And then you get all these neuropeptides and you get the stem cell signaling into the brain along with, you know, billions of exosomes. And then you'll just start noticing your brain quiets down again. So for those of you who are struggling, but you found this fascinating and you want to go deeper, then watch my next video on what is Dihexa used for. I'm Regan Archibald. Really appreciate you being part of this community, and I'll see you on the next video.